We got anybody on set doing? We got nobody here on set. Is that just me, or is everybody missing today?
I'm logging in right now.
I'm running.
Thirty seconds till the radio, gentlemen.
I love that Flynn's on there.
Everybody, this is Laz.
This is Jack. Welcome to another edition of Lunch with Laz and Jack, where we interpret the news so you don't have to.
That's right.
You like the way I snuck in there?
I saw you on camera, and of course, you come running in, and Led Zepp just appears just in the nick of time and on cue on set, like, quiet on the set, places everybody, and all of a sudden you guys just run into your seats today. But anyway, welcome to the show today. For the record, it is Tuesday, December 6, 2016, here inside Shroud of the Avatar. Holy crap, I'm banging that level there.
If anybody, yeah, it's all good. It's all good.
Well, I think I'm blowing us out on the radio.
Well, probably knowing you, but yeah, that's beside the point.
Yeah. But anyway, we're coming off the weekend. Of course, we were not here yesterday, and we're back with all sorts of new great stuff. You're going to see a few changes coming up to the streams here.
Are you referring to the fact that we're both on screen right now?
That's right.
Whereas normally they would only get one of us, not both of us.
You'll notice that you'll be able to see Jack over here and on my side and vice versa. And I got to go look at that and see how that's
green screen. Let's see Jack's green screen.
Yes, well, there actually are other options. And again, I'm in the middle of a rainstorm, so my picture that I normally have is a little off balance today. And of course, we're playing with some of this, but I just got to see how it looks there.
Yep.
Getting a very heavy background effect from my screens because of this storm.
My ears were some jets.
I'm playing around with a little bit more with the filtering on Laz's, so I've pretty much got him completely grid skied out. Yeah.
He don't do the same to you, though.
Yeah, well, we're running different versions of software right now, and if you'll notice up on my screen, I'm using a couple of the new plugins for Discord. Everybody who's in Discord is showing up on the left-hand side of the screen. So welcome, everybody. And, of course, whoever is talking will be highlighted up there. We've got the new Discord server app up in the top. You can see the actual address to the Discord server. But if you can't type that in and you want to come see us, you can go to nbnn.info. Use the Discord app right there on the webpage. Or if you already got Discord, you can type in discord.me/NBNN, and that'll whisk you right on into the green room. And why are we in the green room?
Because we're too damn lazy to move anywhere.
That's right. Too damn lazy to get to the on-air room just one click below us.
See, you did mine. I did mine a little bit differently than you. My Discord is on the right-hand side. And what it does is it actually just says it only displays who's talking now.
Yes.
Yes.
Is I've got everybody in the room so that people like Led Zepp can't claim he wasn't here. You know, I actually have it.
People in the voice chat. There are still a bunch of people that are in the text chat that can't participate on a daily
basis. That's right. And of course, Blood Omen actually is one of those people who's usually in our Twitch chat. I see him actually sneaking in today.
Oh, yeah. He's in both today.
Yes, which is nice.
He just wants to show his love. Yeah.
But a lot of interesting stuff over the weekend. We've got, of course, newsletter number 205, update of the Avatar 205 in the wings. We've got postmortems. We've got all sorts of other interesting tidbits going on out there.
Are you referring to the most recent update that came out to yesterday?
Which one are we referring to here?
The update that came out yesterday. They're making a Blue Bay continued and Xenos polish.
Yeah, I was talking about Friday's, which was just the Xenos polish and Blood Bay. Yesterday's is probably just a rehash of Friday's newsletter. At least the way I'm seeing it.
Did I ever tell you that I don't like YouTube for some odd reason? It didn't save my changes yesterday, and it didn't save them today.
Hang on a second.
Awesome.
Got a message from one of our guildmates, Wannabe Willie, and he tells me to jump on TeamSpeak. We can chat.
Did you tell him
you'd be in the guild?
did you say, hey, you're doing lunch with Laz and Jack?
No, but I can slide on over there real quick and run down and go, dude. Yep. Well, see, I'm on
lunch
the TeamSpeak, and he's not even in there.
It's all good. Tell him to go to discord.me/NBNN and see what happens.
I'm telling him to come join us.
Yes, that's much better. Oh, you can no longer cast light while seated. Yep. No. I'm live on air.
If you're
live,
to
what about
him?
Are you sure?
Yeah.
Are you sure you're live
on
air?
You guys.
Are you positive?
And freaking Led Zepp's got to fucking hit me up with chat so that when I hit /R, I was about to send it to him instead of the right guy. Goddamn bastard.
Oops. Everybody should whisper Laz right now and say, boo, so that way he cannot /reply.
I already got it.
Okay, so did you want to go over the making of Blood Bay continuation and Xenos polish since we do have that lovely update?
Give me a
second. Or did you want to go straight into that fun thing called the stand-up corner?
Do we want to do the polish update, or we want to do update of the avatar and cover it there? I mean, I can go either way. I'm easy. I'm willing to learn new things. You know that.
Well,
I'm guessing there's a reason why we want to go into this one. So.
No, there's not.
The making of Blood Bay continues.
Oh, so you displayed it without like saying, okay, let's do
no,
it.
No, I haven't displayed it. I'm just reading what's on screen over there. I haven't displayed anything yet.
Oh, okay. Well, were you going to stand up first or making a Blood Bay?
No, well, let's go to making a Blood Bay. Let's get that up on screen. Now, this is going to be interesting. I got to see if this is organized right when I put this up. So,
hopefully you clicked on the actual link for it, so that way you get the more pictures and everything else.
I got to bring this up front then. I got to...
Okay. Blood Bay is the newest scene done by Travis Vascorpor Koleski, who is one of the new scene designers. Blood Bay, remember, is going to be a PvP town with a virtue side and a chaos side. Or as other people have...
Penis.
as people have compared it, it is Mario Land.
Mario Kart Land.
That's right. So we do have a lot of pictures of the scene in progress from Travis. So if we start looking through those, we can see the swampy trees. So they've got those new speed trees that they've been adding, as well as a little bit of lava and some nice mountains. He doesn't go into all of the distribution of where things are going to be. I don't know whether or not like you're going to have like actual. I'll reserve my disappointment with the pictures that I've seen before for another day, like when it's actually released.
And of course, like most people, oh, you're on air. I don't want to bother you. Sorry.
No.
We invite you guys, the audience, to come join
us.
That's what we do. That's our gig. So a few more shots. Looks like, it's raining. Why does that not surprise me?
Yeah. Then let's see. I got a little bit too much red on my filter, so I gotta fix things.
I gotta fix things. Green screen up again, real quick.
You have to get it set up for me too, so that way
Switch over. But now today's lighting, of course, because of the storm out there, is screwing with my regular lighting, which is messing with my normal green screen settings. And causing all sorts of fuzzy looking stuff on my side, but that's all right.
Well, what's really funny is my preview, it doesn't actually like completely get rid of me. It just gets rid of the background, but on the actual air thing, it actually gets rid of like half my head.
All right, so making a ghost. Blood bay.
I'm a ghost. Making a blood bay. It's just scenery pictures from there. Then Xenos Polish, we do have a lot more. Remember, Xenos is being done by Scotty. And it's not the Cult of Scotty. What are we calling Scotty's group?
We haven't actually come to it because we figure Cult of Bob, you can't have two cults. But we were thinking like Tribe of Followers
Church.
Of. Church yeah. of.
Sycophants. What do you want to do?
Psychopaths of.
Yeah. the one thing that I really do love about Scotty's work is the fact that he pays attention to architecture, and he bases things off of like pre-existing architecture and tries to include those elements in the scenes that he designs. Because if you look at the Roman columns and the Greek aqueduct in back, you've got all kinds of classical influence. Or sorry, Greek columns. Those are Greek columns. Greek, not Roman.
Greek.
Blah. Yes, the Greek influence.
I'll be right behind.
I know. I'm waiting for someone to actually say something about that. That's not Roman. That's Greek. Dumbass. Not an architecture student. Never taken an architecture class. Don't do it.
It's that nation with all the columns.
Well, the other thing about like Scotty's posts is that it's all about storytelling, because he actually takes the time of day into account whenever he's actually designing these. And he's like talking about the sunset, and this is what it's going to look like at night, and you can see how this is lit, and he's taking into account all the different aesthetics.
And he makes sure you get all that effect, which is which is really cool. Of course, there's nothing like actually listening to him telling the stories.
Oh yeah, I mean every time you. I'm in the office. It really turns into Scotty hour and hugs.
Hugs. Scotty hour and hugs.
It's like, dude, it's like, I love you, man.
I love you, bro. You're still not getting my Bud Light.
You go with the kisses, I go with the hugs. So, yeah.
I was raised in a big Italian family. What can I say? Everybody kissed everybody. Unlike the Greeks.
Well, they did a little bit of something extra.
Greeks don't want no freaks.
Yeah, yeah. Oops. That wasn't supposed to go there.
Now I've got to figure out how to change that the Discord speaker thing so it displays everyone.
Okay. Yeah, you have to actually go into the widget and copy and paste out the change. No big deal.
No, you don't.
No, you don't. All you do is just click it and it changes.
If you go into the properties and if you look at what it's doing, you just read everything.
Oh, you're just going to go change the modifier in the code. Yeah, show off.
Until I turn around and I accidentally see names, and then I turn it to true when it was false, and oh that's hide names. Whoops. Yeah, it's all good. It's all good. So, you ready for something else? So that way I really can't do this until later.
Okay. Stand up.
Stand up?
Stand up?
Yep.
Can we do a stand up corner?
No, we can't do the stand up. We could never, ever, do stand up.
What do you got? Because Fridays? Mondays.
It's like, duh.
Monday. Hey, he's still got a mustache on. He's got to take that off.
Who? Are you referring to Chaox's
picture? Chaox's avatar, yeah.
Well, okay, so there is some good news out there for a lot of people. The QA server should be up soon. Should be. But since I'm the one that gets to read the stand-up corner, I get to decide which day I'm going to read. And I'm going to read yesterday's, Monday, December 5th. After that, we'll go over the update. No, I don't care what you said. Am I supposed to pay attention to you?
No.
Distractions.
Huh?
Distractions.
Who are you again? Squirrel. Okay, so remember, stand-up corners where devs sit there and say, hey, I was working on this yesterday, I'm working on this today, and then something random gets written down, and that randomness we get to interpret as to what they actually mean by it at a later date. So yesterday in the stand-up corner, over in the art department, Leo said he was working on pickup sounds.
Oi, my back.
Oh. Ow. I think I pulled something. Reed was working on the snowball box and the frozen fountain
box.
And bugs.
Bug.
Over in design, Brandon was working on offers and merchant pricing.
I'll make you an offer.
Can't refuse. Yeah. And recipe. Just one recipe, no others.
Recipe.
That's right. Recipe. Just one. Just one, and you're never going to guess what it is. Seawolf.
Seawolf.
Was working on Vauban Pass Village and bugs.
Bug.
Dan was working on spite NPC behaviors. And the mortuarium update.
The mortuarium.
That's right. I don't know why they just can't call it a mortuary.
Well,
next they're going to start referring to the gymnasium, and everybody's going to be exercising naked, and then I'm going to complain that
gymnastics.
I'm not wearing cloth and damage.
Gymnastics. There you go.
That's right.
Gymnastics.
That's right. Fire Lotus is working on the new Spite NPCs.
Spite.
Sanio was working on bugs.
Bug.
And Brittany Sewer's puzzle. And
like it's not puzzling
puzzle.
Enough.
Well, the more puzzles we add to the game, the better. And player documents. And Siege. Lom the Mad.
Lom the Mad.
Has decided that he wanted to work on the Bananarama catalog while working on Songs for Jira. And the Crypt of the Avatar.
Is he now working with Richard on Jira songs? Is that what that is?
I, I don't know, but
are we cataloging
you know what?
Those now? I guess we'll see.
We need more Bananarama. I just want more Bananarama. When I was a kid, the things I used to do to those songs that we won't discuss.
Like in dancing private. Around oh, naked my. In front of your TV, shaking it.
Well, I don't know if there was dancing. Yeah.
Oh, move your ass.
Sorcerer Steve was working on the Ardoris architecture upgrade. And Travis was working on Jira Triage and Blood Bay.
Blood Bay.
Over in tech, Bobby was working on logging, location parsing, and heat maps. Then Jason was working on asset bundles and bugs.
Bug. He said asset.
That's right. Jim.
Mr. Cherry. He's going to pop some rewards.
Hey, wait. I have to talk to you about that real quick. Justin says never, ever say that. She will, like, jump through the microphone and kill you.
What's that?
No, popping of the cherry.
Oh, I still missed something there.
Yeah.
Message it to me.
Yeah. Offline were rewards. Wizard Smoke. He's working on tiered item effects.
Tiered effects. Silence. Shh. Silence.
Shh. I was typing. The Deathbringer, one and only, working on performance. Burning Toad.
Performance.
Still scratching the itch while he works on interactive teleporters and giving everybody just the tip entry.
Just the tip.
And then Tassilo was working on looking at numbers and trying to decide, is this metric or is this standard?
Don't know.
I don't know. Imperial units, I mean... don't know what I'd do without him. Over in QA, Eric was there by himself as he worked on form bug reports. He's still trying to figure out how to upgrade the Wi-Fi and working on testing someone's sanity.
Boy.
Then our production management and other group, we had Brecken, who was trying to figure out where the hell the reliquaries are with the data tracking and shipping, and going through and becoming Lumbane Jr. with Story Jira's. You got that?
Got it.
Story Jira's.
That's right. The Dippy Bird was working on performance and texture crunching and memory leaks. Gorn! He was working on the update of the avatar and general business. Barrick was working on the hospitaler meeting and internal report and add-on store support. Chaos decided that, hey, I'm going to help out a little bit with customer service. And then I'm going to figure out, you know what, all these new bundles, there might be some bugs. And then rewards. And, you know what, I'm going to help out my wife.
He's chasing
and I'm going
to
be
around trying and to I'm, do some of that I'm, reliquary track.
That's right.
I think he
that's
just
right.
enjoys
I was
chasing
there.
The wife around to begin with, but that's another story.
You know what? I have seen him chase her around the office with a sword and poker.
I believe that is true.
And then last but not least, this Dark Star was working on the update and forums and quarter one release 38 planning. And that is what our devs were working on or said they were working on yesterday.
Yay!
Yay!
Cheer from the audience.
Yay!
Thank you, Sid. And just over here is where you can take all that bullshit. That's right. very interesting. I did not know that. We will talk about that later because that's
what didn't you know?
what you just whispered me.
Oh, that's a conversation for not around here.
That's a conversation for, in private. Wow, we got a lot of people sneaking in here today, so welcome everybody.
Well,
it's got Timmy.
I need to fix that on a, is it that Timogen?
That's it, Timmy. Timmy's here.
Timmy's here?
Of course, Mud is
better than him, of course. Mom made it.
Mom made it. And of course, a lot of our usual regular irregulars, but Jacob White's been hanging around. Jacob, how's things going on Soda Map? We've been pushing and prodding the guys down there, and I know that Barracks went ahead and did a little tweet out about Soda Map, and I hear we may be seeing something coming up this week. Pushing Navigator in one of the announcements. Have you spoken to Barrack yet?
No, I didn't spoke to him. I just saw the message that he sent to us.
Well, we actually sent that out to him at your request. So if you get a chance to reply in there and sit down and explain a little bit more about it, or again, we can do that in there, but... Of course, chime in and say hello in that conversation, because we're going to try and get that feature request done.
Yeah, sure. I will.
Yep, it's all going to work out.
Now, hang on a second. We were in the Hospitallers meeting this Sunday, and of course there was chat about actually bringing that live to the radio. And I'm just curious what people would think about that in here. Some of you folks are actually part of the Hospitallers, and some of you folks actually take in part of those activities. But just curious, I mean, would you think it would be beneficial for the weekly meetings to be broadcast where they can be listened to and heard? And of course, if people are running around the game on Sunday, they happen to tune in, they can actually hear and listen into what's actually happening. And then, of course, come join in like you guys do here with us on the air. Any thoughts on that from anybody here in the room?
Nope. Never heard of it. Crickets. What are you talking about?
Crickets.
Squirrel? No one wants to chime in. You know that.
I know.
You know you should never do that ever without like prefacing it with something else.
Like what?
I have no idea.
Exactly. We ask. I really miss all the bards. All our bards got to stop being on strike and get their butts over here.
That's right. Okay. Let's see.
So we've got the stand-up out of the way. Do we have anything really in the newsletter?
No. Well, I would have to go find it again. All updates as I try to continue to fix my that silly thing called my green screen, because I don't like the way that it's like putting static on stuff.
Well, of course, this is something we can talk about. This new tech here. What you're seeing here us using right now, I've got Jack and I are in a meeting room on a new app. Well, I don't know if it's new, but new to us.
New to us, yes.
One of the community members was kind enough to open up a video chat room. It can hold up to 50 people, and everybody in the community is welcome to join in. So, of course, to help promote this a little bit, Jack and I have decided to, of course, use it as part of our show to demonstrate the features of it. And today we're just showing you just a little taste of what we can do here as we get people convinced to come in and actually show themselves on camera.
Well, I don't know. We're barely touching the surface of the features. We have decided to just go ahead and put both of us on screen at the same time.
Yes. Now, I don't know if I'll eventually phase out the actual use of the green screen down here in the bottom, or whether we'll go that way and just, do the Brady Bunch.
You could always do it the easy way and turn around and actually like upgrade your version of OBS to the same one I'm using, so that way you can actually change that filter.
Yeah, oh. But I haven't quite seen. And then, of course, if I've got you green screened and me green screened and there's 9 other people in there, it really doesn't help because they ain't got no green screen. So that just breaks
that's okay.
The effect.
As long as you know that green, it's all good.
It's better to look good than to feel good. And darling, your green screen looks marvelous. Marvelous, darling. Marvelous.
Yeah. I was going to tell you the weekend update. Not that impressive.
Yeah, well,
we've already covered.
There's a lot of that there, and of course, as we were going down on Friday, the calendar actually came back up, which was funny as all hell.
Yeah, right at the end. Absolutely.
Right at the end. But what do we got? We got, of course, QA is going to be coming out shortly. For those of you guys, again, not paying attention, this is today's December 6th. We are a little over a week away from the next release. The next release is going to be the 15th of December here in Shroud of the Avatar. So anybody who is not paying attention and doesn't realize that
I know what we should be talking about right now. It's something that was tweeted out yesterday.
Which tweet? There was a lot. Oh, Ultima Codex?
No.
I've got that loaded up as well. That's my next story.
Ultima Codex killing their IRC server.
Yeah, it's going to tick off a lot of people. So let's just jump to that real quick. For those people who have been, and this has been an ongoing fight in the community, sort of what's going on hospitaler-wise as well is why I bring it up. There's a lot of this going on. People don't like new technology, and of course here we are throwing newer technology at them while they're still fighting the technology that they were throwing, a couple months ago, which is Discord.
Here's my ICQ number.
Yeah, here's my ICQ number. Call me. 178-3147. If you want me on ICQ, that's my number. Look me up and send me a message. No, literally, that's my number.
I have no idea what mine are.
178-3147. That is my actual ICQ number. Everybody's old school, long
mine's
love.
Mine's 867-5309.
867. Yeah. If you want to call
Jenny
me,
Jack.
You can call that
Jenny
number.
Jack.
Actually, if you ever want to call us here in the studio, and again, we'll touch on that again in a minute. For the longest time, IRC was what everybody was using in Shroud of the Avatar. The old schoolers got the IRC channel in, and that was the go-to back in the day when they first got started. That's where you had to go if you wanted to win prizes during the live streams. And, of course, with the advent of Discord, when Beric joined the crew, he made a couple big moves, of course, stepping on a few people's toes and making some people mad. But, of course, again, a lot of these changes are for the greater good of the community. Yes, not everybody's going to be happy. I was one of those people who was unhappy that he was not going to support YouTube except in replays because I just like the YouTube stream better.
Right.
You know what? The YouTube stream has 1/5 the viewers of
Absolutely.
Twitch.
And, for the better good, I understand that. Now, do I like it? No. But anyway, Discord came along, and Beric switched everybody over to Discord, and everybody screamed and moaned. And they actually bent over backwards, and somebody got the code so that they can actually include IRC, because basically Discord is just a glorified IRC in such a way, or there was a hook.
It's just a bot that connected the two of them. Yeah.
But as of a couple of days ago, this was published by WTF Dragon. The Ultima Codex's IRCs are no more, and that includes the Shroud of the Avatar IRC chat channel that was located. That's right.
Are you sure about that?
Yes. If you read the story here, one of the things that the official Shroud of the Avatar IRC channel is no longer available. First paragraph, bottom. Gone. Bye-bye. So it wasn't just the Ultima Codex itself, all of the IRC channels that were hosted at Moongate are now no longer supported. So for those of those folks who don't know, that's the news. So if you're trying to connect to that, it is no longer available. And if you read the rest of the article.
The reason for it, it's also because more people have adopted to Discord than to IRC. So it's if you're finding a newer technology that supports more users, you know what? You're really not going to upset the people that don't want to adopt.
Oh, man. I got to get rid of my modem, man.
Nonetheless, but again, as in video game development, we hear Star and them guys say it all the time. Is when we're making decisions, we got to figure out how many people, what's the least amount of people we're going to piss off today making this decision, because you're always going to be pissing off some part of the community. Who are we going to piss off the least? Which is the best way to make more people happy without many people complaining? That's basically what it comes down to. Sad day nonetheless, because that's some old school stuff that we all grew up with, and of course now it's gone. It is no longer there. So what did you have? You had something else aside from the Ultima Codex.
Yeah, I posted it in Discord.
Oh, well, I'm doing three other things. So give me a second.
It's the Ardoris Guard.
Ah, the Ardoris Guard outfits. Gotcha, yes.
Yep. You know what? That's new information. Yay! And more information. And so there was an official post to the Sketchfab for the Shroud of the Avatar team. Yay! And you gotta love this new guard.
Well, I don't know. I've looked at it personally, and I've actually questioned the look.
What do you question? The colors?
Well, not even that. This guy looks like a glorified scarecrow to me.
That's all guards are.
Well, I mean, literally, he doesn't look like he's really intimidating as a guard to me. It looks like he should be standing out in the middle of a field,
Pink.
With some straw hanging out the bottom of his leg.
You'll run away.
Huh?
Just change the colors to hot pink, and then you'll be running away.
Yeah,
all day.
Or Willy.
That's right. I want to kiss him if you change the colors to hot pink.
Right.
But, I don't know. Let me get this down here and get a little close-up.
Upskirt.
Yeah. I don't know. I just, for the City of Lovers, it's supposed to have the more oriental type feel. I don't see it. Maybe the colors are wrong.
Well, you have to remember that he chooses these colors for the models because they're high contrast.
I mean, the guy looks like he's wearing a Batman mask, for crying out loud.
You have to remember that whenever we get to the actual, the set of Batman.
Come on, man! You gotta see it.
They're going to have two sets of guards. One for the princess. The other one for the Shogun.
Come on, get out of here!
I'm Batman.
Gotta put a little white eyebrows up there, man. You got a Batman mask.
Batman. Yeah.
I'm Batman. Now I'm gonna say. And I'm going to say that every time I run by one of them when they finally put them in. Got to make myself a little macro. I'm Batman. Oh, yeah. Na-na-na-na-na-na-na. But no, I mean, I know they do a lot of work, but I'm hoping that the next round of guards are a little bit... I don't know. It doesn't do anything for me. Maybe it does for anybody else.
Well, when you start thinking, as soon as he starts changing these colors of the uniforms, because the mountain side, they're using the more yellows and greens, and the love side are going to be using more reds, it changes the look of the armor. substantially. So I don't know whether or not these colors and the color scheme are just temporary or not. And if it's temporary, that's better for us.
Yes, that, well, again, is at least it's different from the guard we have. I've seen many a game where they just take the same guard and they change the color of the clothes and they call it a new guard. So,
well, they didn't even do that for all of the other guilds. We do know that they are working on the regional clothes and the regional, I don't know whether or not that's going to be regional accents as far as dialogue or not.
Well, sure. We know that some accents speak fluent feline.
Meow.
Right? Meow. Meow.
Meow.
And we've seen it. Now, of course, places like out in Exeter, I like having the different type, the different race of guard out there with the, the satyrs out there running around as the guards with the fawns all over the place. I like seeing the use of different races per se. I guess we gotta wait for more races to be introduced into the game.
What do you mean by races? Are you referring to the things that actually make it in the book?
Kobolds, satyrs, elves, humans, orcs.
So you're referring to the bestiary?
No, bestiary and races are different things. Bestiary is, raising your farm animals
playable
and all that
races?
Stuff. Which is not to be confused with bestiality, which is what Led Zepp practices all the time out there.
You
mean playable races?
it doesn't matter whether it's playable women or not. Right now we do actually have several playable races. You can play a kobold, you can play an elf, you can play a snowman.
That's only if you wear the mask.
A headless.
We have kobolds in game. We have satyrs. We have fawns. We have a bunch of this stuff in game. So what are you referring to? Increasing the number of variety of monsters, or what are you referring to?
Referring to the use of the satyr guards over in Exeter as using a different race as a guard instead of trying to come up with different garb for humans for... Or did you miss that point altogether?
Yeah, I completely missed it because I was squirreling and looking at other things. You should know better than that.
I know. He's chatting with his girlfriend on the other side. He's looking out the window at the pretty girl bending over picking up that cigarette butt.
Wait, was that posted in Discord?
No.
It's like the milk the other day. It's like
we've just totally gone derailed this.
Yep.
All right, moving right along. Getting to be about that time of the day. We're going to start covering a couple other things, but what else we got on tap? There's so much crap going on out there in the world. I don't even know where to start this week coming up. Of course, again, we're rolling out some new things. You're going to start seeing some new features here. And hopefully by the time we get back from our Christmas break, we'll have a little bit of a different format laid out for you guys. And we're going to start the new year right with something different. Hold on.
C-diagram.
I'm still waiting for the QA server to come up. Because the QA server should be up soon. Maybe.
I'm looking for a command that I just cannot find for some reason.
What are you trying to do?
Never mind. I can't find the damn list. And of course, somebody will find it for me.
Well, if you said what you were trying to do, maybe someone already knows the answer.
Well, if everybody knows the command for now, something completely different in four different variations, by all means. But, of course, I just recently changed them, so they're not they're not where they are, and I don't have my list in front of me, that sheet, okay? Does that make sense?
And now for time for something completely different.
Let's see, here it is. Oh, that's why. Should be,
Where's my list?
And now for something completely different.
There we go. Or...
Div 2.
And now for...
Where's my elephant?
And now for something completely different.
Or Div 3, yes.
Hey, imagine that. Div has two Fs. Yes.
Yeah. Dope! Thank you.
Dope!
Yeah, of course.
So, what are we working on?
I thought it was about that time to get to that calendar that we haven't told anybody about in the longest time. At least since last Thursday.
What is this calendar thing that you're talking about?
I don't know.
I'm a community calendar for Shroud of the Avatar, created by the community, the community.
Which community calendar are we talking about? There's so many community calendars out there.
The one hosted by Avatar Circle, which is also where you have permissions to add things to, and like 30 other people have permissions to add things to the community calendar.
So if your event and that's also that
hosted
calendar.
Off the NBNN website, NBNN.info, just click on the calendar button. That calendar? The one administered by Kazen Phoenixfire in game, or you may know him as Wrath Phoenix, or on Discord or on the official forums, where all times are Central Standard Time in the real world, but we prefer to refer to it as New Britannia Time. That community calendar, is that the one you're talking about?
Nope. No, that's not the one I'm talking about. The one I happen to have up on screen there? No.
Okay.
Totally
the one that has
calendar.
At noon 3:06 and 9 and 12 around the clock, there are two idiots that don't know what the hell they're doing on a show called Lunch with Laz and Jack on WRFB.
WRFB.
That's the one. RadioFreeBritannia.com. At 2 o'clock this afternoon, we do have the Paxlayer Town Manager Hour, so you can go hang out with Sean Silverfoot and learn all about Paxlayer and any and all of its boroughs, including Dragonwatch, Tentakill, Lockbriar, Island of Wonders, Nowhere, Sea Nymph Grotto, and Serenity Isle. If you're looking for some PvE, that's right, tonight's the night. At 3 o'clock this afternoon, you can join the EVL Euro Dungeon Crawl, and that's going to be led by Wintermute Offcough. At 7 p.m. is the Tuesday edition of the EVL Monster Mash Dungeon Run, which is going to be hosted by Zenny this time, and it's going to be starting on the overworld map outside of Owl's Head. And that's also the same for Winter Meets Dungeon Run. If you're not up to the dungeon runs with the EVL crew, you can always join the Jade Dragons and Maul Hari for the dungeon run of Chilblain's Compendium of Pain and Suffering.
And 3 hours worth of suffering.
Hey, that's only 3 hours if your group doesn't know what the hell they're doing.
Okay, 2 hours of suffering.
And it's not very painful. It's relatively easy.
Yeah, it can be fun. It's a... Couple times you run it, if you don't know what you're doing, you feel like you're suffering. It was aptly named, that's for sure.
Yes. Then after that, 8 o'clock this evening on Avatars Radio, we have Dr. DJ Sully doing Faster and Louder.
Louder!
And then last but not least, this evening on Avatars Radio, we do have Temper Tantrum Tea Days with Emberflame. Yeah, that's right.
My radio. And that's our community calendar
for Tuesday, December 6th in Shroud of the Avatar.
Shroud of the Avatar.
Yep. Oh yeah, so I set you up on my screen to where I can like reach out and it looks like I'm about to smack you upside down.
Did you? I gotta pull this up now and see what this freaking guy's up to.
The only problem is it cuts off right before your head. So,
Did you put it side by side?
Yeah, I did.
With a backhand, yeah. Smack.
Yeah, so yeah, if I guess I'm gonna have to upgrade to the newer version of the software.
Why? I mean, because it's a
the green screen thing doesn't work with my version of it, the older version of OBS.
Oh, so you got to figure it out.
But
that's right.
Yeah, I hate when that happens. And besides, it make your ugly mug look better if I had your green screen working. What can I say? I kiss you anyway.
Yeah.
Actually, I prefer to lick his head, but just to
tell. Yeah, everybody does.
That shiny thing.
I haven't trimmed in a few days, so it's a little stubbly.
You want to tell people about that post you shared about shaving your ass hair last night? Or do we have a minute?
That was from 2004. Okay.
Wait, where did you, I mean, you just seemed like you had that one on tap.
I googled it. I remember the story, so I googled it just because it's just too dance. It's just too funny.
Oh, I see.
Way too funny. Yeah. What are you looking for?
Wannabe Willie is. He said, you know, earlier he said, come on into TeamSpeak and join me. I'm new to the guild. So I'm sitting there on TeamSpeak and I'm going, I don't see nobody in there named Wannabe Willie. And, you know, so I told him to come to Discord and people can actually see this on my chat. And he says, I'm Wannabe Willie in Serpent's Watch. So while we were in Serpent's Watch for Eclipse's birthday, I popped in over there and I'm assuming that he guesses that I'm a member of his guild because I was in the Serpent's Watch TeamSpeak. I guess he doesn't get that the girls and them, they use it for broadcasting, and half of those people there weren't even in his guild, so we just hang around with them a lot. It's Serpent's Watch guys is Wolftum from of course Wake Up New Britannia, and got the update. This is coming off next week, thank goodness. So a week from tomorrow I'll be losing this and I'll be back to my usual technical difficulties, self-breaking things
as we try new things and experiment.
Well, you know, always willing to learn.
Hey, new things aren't bad for you. That's all I gotta say.
But meanwhile, we gotta start wrapping things up here. And of course, I know we hadn't given quite a whole lot of love to our sponsors the last couple shows because we've been running late. We've been running soapboxes. We've been just doing wild, crazy, wacky stuff.
What are you talking about?
I don't know, but I'm talking about those good guys over at the Auchinshire Markham Farms, where you can get your wholesale cotton reagents, vegetables, and ales. They're located out in Dawn's Keep, just south of Central Brittany. As well, they've got a store out on the Shroud Marketplace, so if you want to go ahead and buy stuff, you just ain't got the time and you need to get that produce, so you need to get those carrots, so you need that cotton to do your tailoring, go check those boys out. Our friend Aureus Coilmore, Scrota's got the kissing bug. And Coilmore Wands, putting the magic in your hands. Coilmore Wands starts with nothing but exceptionally crafted wands and then goes ahead to modify them to what you want. Custom-crafted wands for the magic that you need. The Britannian Mining Company wants you to come check out Black Rock Cove. They've got everything from a PvP arena, capture the flag style. They've got Market Road where you can get all your mats at all stable prices. All vendors sell the same materials at the same prices, so you'll never have to haggle. Unless, of course, you want to. Check out Black Rock Cove over in the Quell area, right next to the Exeter Mines. Our good friend Jacob White, hanging out with us, the author of Soda Map, and of course Soda Navigator. SodaMap.com is truth, so says Lord British. If you ever get lost, you need to find your way, you just having a tough time navigating, check out SodaMap.com for a quick reference. Or if you really want to know your way, get Soda Navigator. Just use the drop-down box where it says More up to the side. Click on Navigator, download and install it, and you'll have a map running on your side that will keep you right up to date as to what's going on. SodaMap.com with Jacob Weiss. Our friend Ben over at Relic Spy Rilled. RelicSpyRilled.com for all your licensed Shrouded Avatar swag. If you need patches, you need t-shirts, you need comic books, you need drinkware, you want hoodies, you want the newest Shrouded Avatar design, you want the NBNN I Love This Shit bumper sticker, and just like the one I'm holding up here on camera, go out to RelicSpyRilled.com, check them out. You can get all those goodies. And if you want to save a little money on all that swag, use the promo code NBNN and save 10% on your purchases out at RelicSpyReel.com. Our friends over at SodaTaming.com, SodaCraft.com, and SodaCrafting.wiki, these guys still have some relevant information, but it's not going to be helping out much. And I really got to say, I'm bummed for these guys, but I got to thank them for their support anyway. Not going to be as useful of a tool as they were early on. For those of you guys who got a chance to use those tools while they were relevant, I want to thank these guys for all their efforts and hard work. But of course, I got to say, we're going to be dropping these guys off the regular daily list just due to their relevance. We will thank you guys from time to time for your sponsorship. But the relevance for what the audience needs these days, I think we need to give them more relevant information. So, Jack, so just keep that in mind. And, of course...
That's just a matter of telling me that before the show so that we can upgrade
things.
Well,
I've got them up on screen today. And, of course, you know, these guys have been there for the longest time. Some of them have just been folks who have helped promote us along the way, and we've done the same by helping promote them. But... again, the relevance there has been quite useful, gentlemen, and we again appreciate the support. But unfortunately, the usefulness of those websites has now run its course. But thank you to those guys for the long-running support. And of course, last but not least, our good sponsors over at the Shroud Marketplace. ShroudMarketplace.com for all your virtual vendable needs. And Jack's going to tell you all about the marketplace. And he's got a whole bunch of time today where he ain't got to run through it and go, hey, guys, I'll let him tell you about it.
you know what? Shroud Marketplace is the place to go buy or sell anything Shroud of the Avatar related. Anything related to the game can be bought or sold on Shroud Marketplace. It is free to list your items as long as you click on that vendor registration button. In order to purchase something, you will have to register for an account. If you go through, if you are a vendor and you actually want to put something up for auction, then it's just a matter of contacting the administrator and saying, hey, I want this auction. I want it to run for these days, and this is the starting bid. If you're looking for game gold, there are several vendors selling game gold. If you look at the front page where someone's selling $75.
I'm surprised those haven't sold over the weekend.
100 Kodos for $75, which is cheaper than you can get from Portalarium.
There's that snazzy NBNN bumper sticker right on the
front page. Yeah, the awesome NBNN sticker you can also get at Shroud Marketplace. So anything game related, there are currently 30 different vendors, which are all different players that have decided that, hey, we're going to put our stuff up on Shroud Marketplace because.
All your vendors are your neighbors and friends running around in game there.
That's right. And Shroud Marketplace does do something that can't be done on the official forums, because you know what? There's feedback, and you can actually rate the transaction. You can rate the product. You can rate
you
the
like
vendor.
Unmoderated
so
feedback, like
unmoderated, absolutely
honest feedback.
Yeah. So
you're
if
not
someone
be yelled at for posting because you're
exactly
not talking about something relevant.
Exactly, and you're not going to have your post deleted at some later date because someone else does something? Yes. So, Shroud Marketplace,
don't
buy or sell anything Shroud of the Avatar related, and that includes services. Just like Vaclav has decided to say, hey, here's how much my crafting services are worth. If you want some soda design services, you can contact soda design services. Scrota's music service, where $5 gets you anything you want.
Slacking.
Or if you're looking for an in-game event, you can always contact Weddings and More by Lass.
That's right. If you're looking for a place to hold your event, you need some land, you need a different venue, you need a change of scenery, you're looking to get hitched and want to get married and got a wedding party to dress, come see me at Weddings and More by Lass. We've got all the accommodations and services that you can need, and we'll be here to take care of those for you. Of course, we offer everything from sales to rentals and more. So check out Weddings and More by Lass.
That's right. Which takes us once again to... Yeah, helps me hold down the mic button. The Shroud Marketplace, place to go buy or sell anything Shroud of the Avatar related. Click, if you want to become a vendor, just click on vendor registration. You put in your PayPal address and you can be up and running in no time at all. Pineapple.
You don't say that word. Yummy. You don't go tossing that word around these rooms. You get in trouble for that, too.
Which one?
Pineapple.
Oh, yeah. Pineapple. Bad word. Which means it is time for us to thank the most important people around here, and that's you guys watching out on Twitch, YouTube, or listening on Radio Free Britannia.
Carrie.
Carrie wants you to know that she's got the puke face followed by the lick.
Yep.
So,
pineapple.
Yeah.
Yum. Pineapple.
But yes, we got to thank you guys for joining us every day, for sticking with us, for watching us, for supporting us. Without you guys, none of this stuff would be possible. Well, yeah, no, it wouldn't be possible without these guys, because otherwise we'd just really be two idiots sitting here talking to ourselves. So thank you guys. Thank you, everybody, for joining us today. We got to wrap it up and get out of here, and we'll be back with more on Wacky Wednesday tomorrow. So stay tuned for more news, sports, information, crazy wild happenings, and the latest from right here inside Shroud of the Avatar. I'm Lass.
I'm Jack.
And we are NBNN. See y'all tomorrow, folks. Thanks for joining us, and we'll be back then. Spank it, baby. Spank it. They can see you on the screen. Spank it. Oh, you're slapping me in the head. I see what it is.
Slapping the back of your head, baby.
Yeah. Smart ass.
Don't know what you're talking about. It's much better that I set it up like that so that way I can do that. I just need to, like, extend it even further.